Alright, in this video, we are going to be learning how to emboss any type of lettering or structure to any part that you have made. So first we need to make a part. This is going to follow very similar format to the text video. So I'm going to make my box, finish it, extrude it. Then I'm going to go ahead and go into my sketch menu. Choose the side I want to put my text on. Draw my text box. Within the text box, I am going to type my text. Get it to the size that I want it to be. I can, again, make sure to highlight first before you change anything. Center. That way it makes those adjustments and changes for you. Hit OK. My text is on there, so I can hit finish sketch. Okay, so far this is the same as the how to add text. At this point then, I need to go into my 3D model, and I'm going to click the emboss feature. This is where I will come down, hover over my words, and right now it's set to come off of the block. So that's what this arrow is. It means it comes off of the surface. And then I can hit OK, and then my letters then would be coming off of the block, like standoff text. Okay. If I want them to go the opposite direction, I would click emboss, click the text. I'm going to choose to have the second option here where it goes in, and I'm going to send the arrow in. You'll see the arrow changes directions here. Once I hit OK, then my text is going to be indented into the structure that I have made. Those are the ways to make the text stand off or to make the text go into your object. You can follow this same format with any object that you draw onto your box. You can have that object stand off or be something that goes into the object. It does not have to apply to text only. The process is the same. Once the sketch is finished on the surface, then you would still follow the emboss and then follow the same exact procedure to make that item stand off. So, if I wanted to do that, if I drew a structure, I'm just gonna freehand a random structure and finish that. If that was the structure that I wanted to have go into the box, I have two options. I could always extrude it, and that could go either way. Curved surfaces is where this embossing is going to be even more important. So that same option applies. I can take that, have that item go in, and that same part will happen. Again, on a flat surface, I can use the extrude feature to go in or up the same way that you see here with a structure. The extrude doesn't work for your text in that manner to go in and out. Curved surfaces is when you're definitely going to find that this is even more important to learning how to use the embossing. An example would be adding the threads to a football. This would be something that you would have to do. You would draw that structure on a flat plane, and then you would have to use the emboss feature to make those threads come off of the football.